Tropical Cyclone Ilsa continues to intensify today off the northwest Australian coast. Widespread, significant impacts are likely across large parts of Western Australia and eventually Central Australia over the coming days. Taking a look at this system in our current satellite imagery, we can see the deep tropical convection off the coast to the north of Broome. Tropical Cyclone Ilsa, currently a Category 2 system, sits in the middle of this rotating bands of convection, showers and thunderstorms. Having a look at our tropical cyclone track map, we can see how Tropical Cyclone Ilsa strengthens to a Category 3 severe tropical cyclone by later today. Because of this intensification, we do have a tropical cyclone watch zone current from Beagle Bay down to Wim Creek and extending into the inland areas to Telfer and beyond. These areas could see winds in excess of 90 to 100 kilometres an hour starting to develop in the next 24 to 48 hours. Through tomorrow, Ilsa is expected to intensify into a Category 4 system, eventually making a coastal crossing somewhere between Broome and Port Hedland either late tomorrow or early Friday morning. Over the next 2 days, we are expecting to issue tropical cyclone warnings for these parts of the coast and likely large parts of the inland as well as this system moves through. The exact location of the coastal crossing is still uncertain, and this is indicated by these areas of white uncertainty here. Following the coastal crossing, Ilsa is expected to move southeast inland, starting to decay quite rapidly by Saturday morning back to a tropical low. As TC Ilsa makes its coastal crossing, we are expecting to see the most impacts in those coastal regions. Wind gusts in excess of 250 kilometres an hour are possible, and winds of this strength have the ability not only to bring down trees and power lines, but lift items from your yard and home, caravans, trampolines. It's essential to make sure that your home and property are secure and that you yourself are safe at this time. Breaking down our forecast a little bit further, we can see how as Tropical Cyclone Ilsa intensifies to severe tropical cyclone, the moisture and winds wrap tightly around the system and begin to impact the coastal parts in our watch area. As Tropical Cyclone Ilsa makes its coastal crossing, this is when we're seeing the most intense rainfall and those most intense winds that I mentioned before. These impacts are really going to ease back as Tropical Cyclone Ilsa decays over the later part of the week into the weekend. Our forecast accumulations over the coming days are initially going to build across northern parts of the Kimberley, but then very quickly along the tropical cyclone track as it moves across the Kimberley Pilbara coast and quickly inland. Along that track area, we could very easily see rainfall accumulations in the 50 to 150 millimetre range. And close to the coast, where we have that intense tropical cyclone coastal crossing, we could see rainfall totals well in excess of 200 to 300 millimetres. This sort of rainfall could very easily lead to flash and riverine flooding. And this is why we have large flood watch areas across parts of Western Australia, extending into Central Australia as well as that system moves inland. In these areas, not only flash flooding is a risk, but also the riverine flooding, which can impact roads and access routes, making tracks muddy or even impassable. This may impact access to some remote communities, so it's essential to be aware of these flood warnings that may change as the system moves close to the coast. As Tropical Cyclone Ilsa intensifies today and nears the Kimberley coast, it's essential to keep up to date with the latest forecasts and warnings via the Bureau's website and the Bomb Weather app. Make sure you listen to and follow all advice from your local emergency services and keep yourself safe. Bye for now.